Chester Patterson of Lauriston Carriacou, a student of the Hillsborough Secondary School, passed away on Friday, 8th March 2024, at the age of 14. She was the daughter of Shireen Alexis, sister of Prince, Haven, Joshua, Israel, and David, granddaughter of Vernal and Malitha Patterson, Cuthbert Snag, and Gemma Guy, great-granddaughter of Florence Snag, niece of Patrick, Alric, Errol, Hyacinth, Pauline, Paulette, Amos, Farron, Stacy, Selina, Kimini, and Noah. Many other close relatives and friends, including the Guy, Snag, Roberts, and Ferguson families, and the Patterson family in Jamaica. The funeral service for the late Esther Patterson of Lauriston Carriacou will take place on Wednesday, April 3rd at 12 noon. Funeral service will be held at the Hillsborough Recreation Ground, and interment will be at the Brunswick Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Anderson Charles Bain, also known as Maskey, Papa Bain and Brother, of Fontenoy St. George, a well-known retired fisheries officer, passed away on Saturday, 9th March 2024, at the age of 84. He was the father of Anthea Rennick, Alison Bain Smith, Alistair Archie Bain, Aloma Bain Street, Anne-Marie Bernadette Bain, Alana Bain, Adonna Thompson, Alain Bain, and Nathalie Woodruff in Trinidad. Grandfather of Cheryl, Johannes, Zithri, Aaliyah, Rishon, Renee and Adoree Bain, Rohan and Paige Passard, Jesse and Jordan Smith, Amy, Daryl and Jane Pascal, Alyssa Thompson Nurse, Taffy Thompson, Dimitri and Glenisha Belfon. Great-grandfather of Yane Bain, Amon and Ariel Thompson Nurse, brother of Joseph and Michael Bain in Canada, father-in-law of Stephane Dufont, Elka Fontaine, Jocelyn Smith, Rohit Passard, Trevor Thompson and Paul Street, brother-in-law of Jean and Janice Bain and Joyce Knights in Canada, Monica Gainell Bain, Lynette Temptress Rennick, Lorna Henry and Leroy Rennick, many nieces and nephews in Grenada, the USA, Canada and Trinidad, including Patrick Thomas, Joseph, Chris, Jeremy, Andrea, Michelle and Jackie Bean, Deidre Wilson, Charmaine Beckett and Nesta Bailey, his caregiver Samantha Samuels. Other relatives and friends including Wendy and Raquel Bean, Glennis Martin Belfon, Cleavon Childs and Erilyn Alexander, Jean Palmer, Trisha Jacob Simon and family, Pamela Joseph and family, Godfrey Duncan and family, Neville Bain and family, Emmanuel Rinky Bain and family, Justin Rennie and the Department of Fisheries, Jean Toussaint and family, Sekou Thompson and family, the Thomas and Jones families, Edmund Patrick and family, the Houghton, Redhead and Folks families of Fontenoy, Dr. the Right Honorable Keith Mitchell, Senator Jonathan Lecret and family, Nimrod Oliver and family, Pastor Thomas Welch and family, Pastor Christopher Baker, Evangelist Brian Worm, and members of the Market Hill Evangelistic Center, and friends and neighbors of Fontenoy, Grandmall, and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Anderson Charles Bain, also known as Maskey, Papa Bain and Brother, of Fontenoy St. George, will take place on Thursday, April 4th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Market Hill Evangelistic Center, and entombment will be at the St. George's Center Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Veda Cynthia Wells, née St. Cyr, also known as Granny, Gran-Gran and Teacher Veda, of Ladigue St. Andrew, retired school teacher and well-known piano teacher, passed away on Sunday, 17th March 2024, at the age of 88. She was the mother of Clarence Leonard Wells, also known as Len, Cecile Wells, Leslie and Charles, Lindona John, Samuel Wells and Jemima Wells, adopted mother of Tessa Walker, grandmother of 21 including Luigi, Sabrina, Sherlyn, Lyndon, Simmons, Michaela, Imoni, Carrie, Mariev, Melida and Calvin, great-grandmother of 14, mother-in-law of Rosemary Wells, Samuel Charles, Sergeant 325 Gabriel John, Luann Wells, and William Andrews. sister of Eric Sincere in Trinidad, Vera and Dennis Sincere in Canada, Claire Clowden in the USA, Anne Sincere, Pearl Sincere, also known as Teacher Pearl, Brandy Sincere, Gemma Sincere, and Walter Sincere. Aunt of 20, including Francine, Vernell Clowden, Lyndon and Gerard Sincere, John and Michael Telesford, and Jacqueline Alexander. Sister-in-law of Joaquin Sincere, Aubrey Wells, Kathleen Drakes, Celia Cruikshank, Roger Wells, Irma Olivassi, and Neville Wells. Aunt-in-law of many, including Roxanne Benoit, Keisha and Leonard Drakes, and Sherma Wells. Cousin of many, including Keith and Adrian Banfield, Verna Lenny, Elise, Yvette, Yvonne, Elaine, Freddie and Rodney Henwood. Caregivers Annie Lessie, Naomi, Teresa and Jennifer. Many other relatives and close friends, including Rachel Charles, Candy Telesford, Myrna Rush, The Fullerton, Henwood, Forbes, Marshall, Banfield, Wells and Sincere families, and friends and neighbors of Ladigue and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Veda Cynthia Wells, née Sincere, also known as Granny, Gran-Gran and Teacher Veda, of Ladigue St. Andrew, will take place on Thursday, April 4th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Grenville Evangelical Church, and interment will be at the Grand Bras Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Nola Noel of Bylands, who resided at Mirabeau St. Andrew, passed away on Saturday 16th March 2024 at the age of 61. She was the wife of Francis Noel Forrester, mother of Dornette Lewis in the USA, Nashida Lewis, Adriel Williams and Kashida Noel in Grenada, grandmother of Amelia Lewis, Kelson Jr., Charles and Camelia Charles, sister of Marilyn Kennedy and Anne Francis in Trinidad, Brenda Lewis, Elizabeth Mitchell, Jacinta Noel in Grenada, Jocelyn Joseph, Megan John, Thomas Joseph, and Sherma Lewis in the USA. Mother-in-law of Jason Alexander, Kelson and Cameron Charles. Sister-in-law of Keisha Marshall, Lyndon Noel, Kenny Forrester, Anthony Noel, Rhonda Hyacinth, Vercel Kelly, and Donnery Noel. Aunt of many, including Vashti Joseph, Karen Lewis, Desiana Nelson, Stephanie Charles, Shania Lewis, and Tamelia Joseph. Niece of Mary and Eileen Joseph. Many other relatives and close friends, including Franklin Batiste and family, Rosalind Mathurin, Charmaine Alexander and family, the Forrester family of Grenville and Paraclete, the Noel, Nash, Collier, Lewis and Joseph families of Mirabeau, Bylands, Birdgrove and surrounding areas, and friends and neighbors of Bylands, Mirabeau and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Nola Noel of Bylands, who resided at Mirabeau St. Andrew, will take place on Thursday, April 4th at 1:30 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Mirabeau Pentecostal Church and interment will be at the Grand Bras Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Marvin Raphael Neptune, also known as Marvo or Felix Park St. Andrew, passed away on Friday, 8th March 2024 at the age of 50. He was the son of Claudette Neptune, also known as Tita, brother of Myrtle Blesdill and Selma Jeffers in the USA, Erla Hazard and Dennis in Canada, Allison and Valwin in Grenada. Uncle of many, including Kathy, Clinton, Garth, Zane, Andrew, Natanya, Corey, Samara, Jewel and Savannah. Nephew of Janet Jones, Pearl Polo and Veronica Alexis in Carriacou, and Gregory Celestine. Brother-in-law of Floyd Hazard, Marlene Neptune, Lincoln Blesdill and Karen Celestine. Many cousins, other relatives and close friends, including Teacher Jean Hagley, Kelly Batiste, cricketers of Mamakan and surrounding areas, the Neptune family of Calivany, the Celestine family of Munich and Latant, the Jones and Polo families, and friends and neighbors of Felix Park, Crowshoe and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Marvin Raphael Neptune, also known as Marvo, or Felix Park St. Andrew, will take place on Thursday, April 4th at 1:30 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the St. Martin de Porres Roman Catholic Church, Crowshoe, and interment will be at the churchyard cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. A memorial service for the late Louise Agnes Cador and Margaret Mary Forrester of Grand Roy St. John will be held on Friday, 5th April at 2 p.m. at the Grand Roy Catholic Church. Arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Joseph Ben, also known as Ben and Toto Man of Trinidad, who resided at Belmont St. George, died on Friday, March 8, 2024, at the age of 63, left to mourn his wife Angela Ben in the United States, mother Gloria Ben in Trinidad, children Marlon and Akim Ben in Trinidad, and Kishona Rouse in Grenada, grandchildren Mariah and Selena Ben in Trinidad, and Kiara Rouse in Grenada. Siblings Kenneth Ben, Ethel Ben in St. Vincent, Barbara, Anne-Marie and Shari Ben in Trinidad. Uncle of 16. Many other cousins in Trinidad, including Renisha Filbert. Close friend of Henry Thompson and family of Belmont, Ryan Pilgrim and family of Jean Anglais, Alice and Kaylee of Circular Drive Frequenty, Ronald in the UK, Richie Maitland and family, Steve, Veru, Robbie, Sue and Brooms and family, Benson at Grenville, Curlin Rouse and family of Springs, the Traffickers in Grenada and Trinidad, and many other relatives in Grenada and Trinidad, too numerous to mention. The funeral of the late Joseph Ben, also known as Ben and Toto Man of Trinidad, who resided at Belmont St. George, will take place on Friday, April 5th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Bailey's Funeral Home, Coronage, St. George, followed by private cremation. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Zephryn Panchu, also known as Panch and Parin, of Sab St. Andrew, passed away on Sunday, 18 February 2024, at the age of 89. He was the father of Shem Panchu, Miranda, Jerry and Willen Clark, grandfather of many, brother of Gloria and Anne, uncle of many, caregivers Kemlin and Matthew Panchu. Many other close relatives and friends, including the Panchu family of Sab and Mirabeau, and friends and neighbors of Sab, Mirabeau, St. Clouds and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Zephryn Panchu, also known as Panch and Parin, of Sab St. Andrew, will take place on Friday, April 5th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Lacroix Brothers Funeral Chapel, Gladstone Road, Grenville, St. Andrew, and entombment will be at the Grand Bras Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home.
When a loved one passes on, we all need the comfort, support, and guidance of a trusted friend. You can rely on Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. We provide a personalized professional service that exceeds all expectations. Our dedicated staff responds to your every need with the greatest detail, ensuring affordability with a variety of options. Upgraded state-of-the-art facilities, spacious air-conditioned chapel with live internet streaming, a modern, environmentally safe crematorium, the only of its kind on island, private viewing spaces, large on-site repast center, a modern transportation fleet. Join our burial society today and make personalized arrangements for that final moment. As you prepare to enter your loved one into eternal rest, visit or call Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home and select a package that brings added comfort to the entire family. Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home and Burial Society, continuing a tradition of excellence.
Elisha Joseph, also known as Diddy, of Hope St. Andrew, who resided in England, passed away on Sunday, March 3rd, 2024 in England, at the age of 87. He was the father of Joel, Mavis and Myrtle, father-in-law of Anthony, stepfather of Patsy, Becton, Yvonne, Elaine, Carlton, Sharon and Louisa, also known as Macy, and their families, grandfather of Joshina, Jada and Jayonsi, great-grandfather of Azari, brother of Isaac, John, Samson, and Samuel and their families. Other relatives include friends in Trinidad, Canada, the United Kingdom, and Grenada, including the Francis family of Roucaine, the Wellington, Japal, and Peters families, and friends and relatives of Hope City, Post Royal and Marquis St. Andrew. The funeral of the late Elisha Joseph, also known as Diddy, of Hope St. Andrew, who resided in England, will take place on Tuesday, April 9th in London, England. A memorial service will be held in Grenada at a later date. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Raymond Davis Lewis, also known as Perrin, Bryna, and Uncle Davis, of Brooklyn Concord St. John, passed away on Sunday, 17th March 2024, at the age of 84. He was the life partner of Nordlyn Mitchell, also known as Nadju, father of Philomena, Wayne, Dexter, Roll, Raleigh, Roland, Dave, Jasmine, Jason, Morgan, Michael, and Avis. Grandfather of 30 in the USA, Canada, Grenada, and Barbados, including Shireen. Great-grandfather of 8. Father-in-law of Lenita, Rachel, Mila, Carla, Trisha, Norman, Nicole, and Marlene. Brother of George, also known as Whitebread in Grenada, Edris and Edna in Canada. Uncle of many, including Warrell, Stephanie, Mustafa, and Kenny. Many other relatives and friends in England, the USA, Canada, Barbados, Trinidad, and Grenada, including Freddie, Yvonne, Kyron, the pastor and members of the Concord Seventh-day Adventist Church, and friends and neighbors of Brooklyn, Concord, and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Raymond Davis Lewis, also known as Perrin, Bryna, and Uncle Davis, of Brooklyn, Concord, St. John, will take place on Wednesday, April 10th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Concord Seventh-day Adventist Church and entombment will be at the Power Park Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. John James Carl Harvey, also known as Metu, of Sendell Street, who resided at Rivulet Lane, Grenville, St. Andrew, passed away on Sunday, 31st March 2024, at the age of 67. The funeral arrangements for the late John James Carl Harvey, also known as Metu, of Sendell Street, who resided at Rivulet Lane, Grenville, St. Andrew, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Rollins Festus Smith, also known as Smitty and Rollo, of Montjaloo St. George, who resided at Marquis St. Andrew, died on Tuesday, 26th March 2024, at the age of 78. The funeral arrangements for the late Rollins Festus Smith, also known as Smitty and Rollo, of Montjaloo St. George, who resided at Marquis St. Andrew, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Peter Castle, of Grand Arne St. George, died on Saturday, 23rd March 2024, at the age of 63. The funeral arrangements for the late Peter Castle of Grand Arne St. George will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Yolanda Moreen, also known as Yoyi, of Latant St. David, passed away on Saturday, 23rd March 2024, at the age of 42. The funeral arrangements for the late Yolanda Moreen, also known as Yoyi, of Latant St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Roy Alvin Noel, also known as Lockett, of Harford Village St. Andrew, passed away on Monday, 25th March 2024, at the age of 87. The funeral arrangements for the late Roy Alvin Noel, also known as Lockett, of Harford Village St. Andrew, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Muriel Bell, also known as Tanti, of Woburn St. George, died on Saturday, 23rd March 2024, at the age of 79. The funeral arrangements for the late Muriel Bell, also known as Tanti, of Woburn St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Irene Bartholomew, also known as Maybell Bartholomew, of Granton, New Hampshire, St. George, died on Friday, 22nd March 2024, at the age of 98. The funeral arrangements for the late Irene Bartholomew, also known as Mabel Bartholomew of Granton, New Hampshire, St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. James Patrick, also known as Yeri of St. John St. Andrew, who resided in Trinidad, passed away on Sunday, 25th February 2024, at the age of 78. The funeral arrangements for the late James Patrick, also known as Yeri of St. John St. Andrew, who resided in Trinidad, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Nettie Albert Hayward, also known as Dido, of Mount Parnassus, St. George, passed away on Monday, 18th March 2024, at the age of 84. The funeral arrangements for the late Nettie Albert Hayward, also known as Dido, of Mount Parnassus, St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Vernessa Harford, also known as Nessie and Nessa, of St. James St. Andrew, who resided at Redgate St. David, passed away on Thursday, March 14, 2024, at the age of 32. The funeral arrangements for the late Vernessa Harford, also known as Nessie and Nessa, of St. James St. Andrew, who resided at Redgate St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Marilyn Agnes Young of Duquesne, who resided at Nonpareil St. Mark, passed away on Monday, 3rd March 2024 in the USA, at the age of 77. The funeral arrangements for the late Marilyn Agnes Young of Duquesne, who resided at Nonpareil St. Mark, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Enid Butler, also known as Auntie Enid of St. Dominic Street, Gwove, St. John, passed away on Tuesday, March 5th, 2024, at the age of 99. The funeral arrangements for the late Enid Butler, also known as Auntie Enid of St. Dominic Street, Gwove, St. John, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home.
The management and staff of MTV extend deepest condolences to those of you whose loved ones have passed on. Thank you for watching.
Whenever loved ones experience death, be it a family member or a friend or a colleague, it brings disappointment, pain, and frustration. This is so because the reality strikes that such a person will not be seen in this life again. Death robs us of our physical life. And Mary and Martha shared this disappointment. When Martha in particular went out to meet Jesus and she said, "Lord, if you were here, my brother would not have died." As much as this sentence could be viewed as a sentence of faith and confidence, it is also a sentence of disappointment and regret. In her grieving stage, Martha was sharing with Jesus that it is literally your absence that caused my brother's death. But Jesus was about to prove to Martha that her grief is temporary and that death does not have the final say. So he said to her, "Your brother will rise again." This is one of the confidence we must develop in this life, that death does not have the final say in a human's life. Death is just temporary. In fact, one Christian commentator says, it is a passageway from this life into the next. So that we have the natural tendency that we must grieve, we must mourn, because we will not see the person. But our faith in God, our hope in God, tells us that this is not the end. Those of you who are grieving the death of your loved ones this moment, I ask you to look away from yourself and look to God for hope and confidence, to know that this is not the last, but your loved one has only preceded you. Paul was so confident that death is not permanent that he mocked death and asked, "Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O grave, is your victory?" In other words, death does not have the victory over those who trust in God. It is just a passage from one life to the other. And the psalmist himself developed that confidence when he says, "Because the Lord is my shepherd, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil." We cannot postpone death. We cannot run it away. But we can go through it and come into that new life with God, that life everlasting. I trust that your loved one's death will challenge you to make your preparation to journey with Jesus through the darkest valleys of life and to come through to obtain life everlasting. May God bless you and comfort you in these moments of grief, and may He carry you along, that you will never be alone, but He will be your friend and your companion. God's peace be with you. Amen.